Alright guys, welcome back, yada yada yada, the video died, yada yada yada, I died right after the video ended, and now, let's finish this game off. Now that motherfucker's charging. Oh wow, that was a direct hit. Come on! You're right there! Just kill me. Wait, I just realized this boss battle, the director of this game, rocket launcher. Oh my god, a Resident Evil cliche. Alright, 3, 2, 1, BAM! 3, 2, 1. No, fuck you! Oh wow, direct hit, and I get a free shot. Bullshit. I fucking missed. Yeah, fuck you. God, Sebastian just can't get a break. Got him? I thought I fucking died. Ew. That's disgusting. Brain. I wonder how long we've been out.
I created this world. You cannot keep me here. Ruvik. I'm going to finish this.
Destroy it. Fuck you, Ruvik.
Vital sign, sir.
Wait, what the hell? What the hell? Whoa!
Leave that
That's
one.
That's the nurse!
And those two. They're not going anywhere. No one can.
I'm so lost right now. Oh, there's a cop. The doctor. Leslie Withers. Wait, that was empty. Oh, shit. Oh yeah, and the title. Well, not title, but the name. Beacon Mental Hospital.
Go, go, go! Detective, are you alright? Is there anyone else?
Just give me some real fresh air.
How did they know that, I mean, it's a SWAT team and all that, so how did they know to go here? I mean, of course they went here, but then, why the SWAT team? You would think it would just be like a regular, you know, just some cops and all that. That's Leslie. That's not good. I guess Ruvik succeeded. And if Ruvik succeeded... I don't think we're out just yet. So that is it for The Evil Within. Whew, what a game. Wow, this was a very long game, which is already a positive. Because I like it when a game feels very long. And my god, this game was long. But I do have a lot of things to say about this game, good and bad. Well, not a lot of bad things. Let's start off with the bad things first. The story... is pretty non-existent for a long period of time during this game. You know, the story starts off, of course, on Chapter 1, and then you still get a little bit of stuff on Chapter 2 and 3. If I remember right, you still get kind of some little bits of stuff, you know, throughout each chapter. But for the most part, during, like, I want to say Chapter 3 to Chapter 10, or no, Chapter 9, the story, or no, was it... chapter 9 or chapter 10, I don't know which, I don't remember which one it was, but the story is pretty non-existent for the most part of this game, and that is a very bad thing, because, I mean, it can be a good thing or a bad thing depending on how you see it, you know, well, depending on how you are, personally. Personally, I thought that was very bad. The fact that there was barely any story development throughout a big portion of this game, I was actually getting kind of bored with the story. I thought my main gripe with the game at the time was that there was no story. And then, finally, in Chapter 10, you start getting all the backstory, and, well, Chapter 9 or 10, and then once all that starts happening, you start getting a lot of backstory and a lot more story to this game, to where I will say the story was really interesting. I actually really liked it. But because of such a big portion of this game had no story, that's a negative. I didn't like that. Not saying the game was bad during the big portion of what I'm talking about. Because I'll say this, positive wise, the game is really fun. I really enjoyed playing this game. I enjoyed it a lot. But, you know, the story, that's really my main negative with the story, is that such a big portion of this game pretty much has little to no story. And the story doesn't really even go anywhere until Chapter 9 or 10, you know, when you go to Bruvik's mansion. Maybe a little bit before, but, like I said, I don't remember when it finally started rolling. Another negative thing I gotta say about this game is, oh, the frame rate. The frame rate can get pretty bad, but it's very rare. I'll say, I didn't have much problems with the frame rate, but there was frame rate problems. It was mainly when a lot of shit was going on, where the frame rate was becoming an issue. Now, my main gripe with this game is the acting. The acting is downright horrid, okay? It's B-movie acting. The characters are very one-dimensional. You don't give a living shit about any of these characters. The only character I have to say that showed death, not death, but like showed more than one personality was the doctor. And that's bad. That is really bad that one actor in this entire game actually showed some depth. Now, earlier I did say like Ruvik did seem like he showed some depth, but overall he was one of the one-dimensional characters that you just don't care about. Though granted, I did hate him. In a good way. I did hate him in a good way. I really wanted to see him dead because he was a fucking asshole. And he was a psychopath. Which I will say, I really loved his story. I thought his story was really good, and I loved the Silent Hill bits of this game. The Resident Evil bits was a little weird for me, because I'm a huge Resident Evil fan, and I know the guy who directed this is directed and created Resident Evil. But for some reason, it just felt weird to me to see these Resident Evil relations, or I don't know how to say it, you know, just these Resident Evil parts in this game. For some reason, it just felt weird. But I did love the atmosphere in this game, the horror in this game. Boss battles were a bitch, okay? And the enemies, very half and half. On the one hand, you have enemies that hack and slash you, cause damage, and then the other half is instant death. And the bosses, you know, they have instant death as well, but they can hack and slash too. So this game has a lot of cheap-ass deaths. It really does. Oh my god, this game was so... Graphical-wise, I think the game did look good, for the most part. Music-wise, I think the music was great. Bosses, even though they were a pain in my ass, pretty fun. I always say this, when a boss battle is pretty difficult, or, you know, a chase type of boss, even if I'm pissed, I do enjoy it. You know, the stuff with Lara, I loved. The safe head, loved. A lot of the bosses, pretty much all the bosses I loved. Except that one in the sewers where that thing, that tentacle thing was going around. That was just easy and kind of sad. But yeah, my main gripe is just with the voice acting and the big story gap of nothing. That's really my only gripe with this game. Gameplay, fun. I'd probably have to give an 8 out of 10. You know, just that big gap of where there was no story, and the voice acting, really downgrades it for me. But I did like the backstory they give for Sebastian. You know, I really did like that. I did kind of feel something near the end when you start having some of the last bit of backstory, you know, last bit of journal entries from him. I did feel a little something when I was reading, you know, that last letter his wife gave him. So I did like that. I just wish they kind of integrated that kind of emotion into Sebastian and just show him actually reacting to all this shit happening. And like I said, it just seemed like he was just, it's like he's been there, done that kind of shit. That's how he reacted during this game. As soon as everything started, he didn't show any emotion to what the hell was happening. Sure, he had some lines like, what the hell, blah, blah, blah. But overall, he just seemed like he's done this before. And as for the ending, I did like the ending. It does leave it for a cliffhanger. Well, it does leave it as a cliffhanger for a sequel. But it does also leave some questions. Like, who the hell...